How about some pop news?
Let's do it, George. Good morning, everybody. We're going to begin with the biggest fashion event of the year, the brainchild of Vogue's Anna Wintour. The Met Gala has become the latest global event to be postponed indefinitely. This year's theme was to be called About Time, Fashion and Duration, co-hosted by Emma Stone, Meryl Streep, and Lin-Manuel Miranda. The last time the Met Gala was put on hold was in 2002 after the 9/11 attacks.
We're hearing that a lot, that it's been not since 9/11.
Yeah, these things not, been postponed. Agreed. Yeah. Well, it is quite serious. Yeah. And a lot of celebrities are giving back during these trying times. Jennifer Garner, Amy Adams, they've started an Instagram page. Check it out, please. It's called Save With Stories, where celebs will read your favorite children's books and donations can be made to save the children and no kid hungry.
Oh,
Jen writing on Instagram, quote, these funds will help make sure families know how to find meals when schools are closed and support programs to help kids make up for time lost in the classroom. And Ryan Reynolds and Blake Lively are also stepping up, the couple announcing overnight they're donating $1 million to be split, between Feeding America and Food Banks Canada, two organizations helping those most at risk and in need. Ryan posting on Instagram, COVID-19 has brutally impacted older adults and low-income families. Take care of your bodies and hearts. Leave room for joy. Call someone who's isolated and might need connection. And then he offers Hugh Jackman's phone number.
He's joking, of course. Much needed humor.
Thank you so much. And thank you so much for your generosity.
Absolutely.
And so many celebrities are using social media to urge their fans to stay inside. Kristen Bell getting rave reviews for her post, which says, quote, our elders were called to war to save lives. We are being called to sit on the couch to save theirs. We can do this.
That is smart.
It's simple. It's so true. Mm-hmm. Bell's sentiment echoing for the call of social distancing among younger people who officials say can spread the virus without having any symptoms. And to that end, Mel Brooks and his son Max have teamed up. The 93-year-old there, he's behind glass safely. Max reminding everyone on the other side of the glass why it's so important to stay inside. Take a look.
If I get the coronavirus, I'll probably be okay. But if I give it to him, he could give it to Carl Reiner, who could give it to Dick Van Dyke. And before I know it, I've wiped out a whole generation of comedic legends.
Well said, Max.
Funny, not funny.
Max, funny, yeah, funny, not funny, but funny and true. Max sharing the video on Twitter on his feed on Monday, and now it has 11 million views and counting. Among them, Mark Hamill, who is using the force of social media to tweet, listen to Max's wise words, everyone. It's great advice, and we simply can't take the risk of endangering Mel Brooks, Carl Reiner, and Dick Van Dyke, who represent a collective 284 years of comic genius. Adding the hashtag, don't be a spreader.
Don't be a spreader.
Don't be a spreader.
It's like the Surgeon General yesterday said, watch out for pop-pop. Remember?
Yeah.
Remember the famous pop-pop?
I say, Mel Brooks looks great.
93 years young. That video was so great. Mm-hmm. Just says it all.
Then
so does this. Finally, there is one group that is very happy that we all have to stay at home. Take a look at the post from The Ellen Show that reads, humans, quote, dang, I need to self-quarantine for 2 weeks. And dog's response, well, the smile says it all. They're glad to have us home, everybody. And that is pop news on this Tuesday morning.
Look at
morning.
That smile.
Great job.
Thank you.
Make a smile, Lara.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.